When some criminals finish their jail term, there can be real fears they will only return to their bad old ways. But a special surveillance operation keeps tabs on the worst of the worst. And tonight, we give you a look inside the bunker where they do their work.
In an office hidden away in Sydney's west, a team of investigators are on a stalking mission.
It's just moving around from there, going down Homebush.
The target is one of 119 high-risk criminals whose mugshots fill a nearby wall.
Let's just do some unannounced visits and some surveillance, maybe see who he's talking to.
Murderers, terrorists, pedophiles on our streets, but on a tight leash after being placed on ESOs, extended supervision orders.
They are out in the community, but they don't enjoy freedom to the extent that you and I enjoy freedom.
Child killer and pedophile Michael Guider has been on the team's radar since his release 2 months ago. He wears an electronic monitor and every week has to outline his every movement in advance.
And then we track them through that week to ensure that movement schedule is adhered to.
Out means out on the street, in means back inside after breaching one of the many conditions. At the moment, nearly half the number of offenders subjected to extended supervision orders have been returned to custody for putting a foot wrong. And the government insists the community is safer for it. Notorious pedophile Warren Hayter was sent back to jail for possessing multiple SIM cards. Adriano Mena, who shot a delivery driver during a botched robbery at Werrington TAFE, was locked up for another 12 months for using drugs. While convicted murderer Corinna Holloway copped a further 10 months imprisonment for consuming alcohol. Critics say the ESOs are draconian, with offenders being set up to fail.
They're not there to trip people up, they're there to keep the community safe.
And it's up to this special group to play babysitter.
So can we get a new photo of him just to update for the board there?
24 hours a day, 365 days a year. Damien Ryan, Nine News.